السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him upon all conditions. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, all his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of them and to bless every one of us and to bless the entire ummah and to bless humanity at large. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from evil and grant us goodness. And at the same time, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the straight path and keep us on that straight path. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, where do I fit in? Where do I fit in when it comes to the message that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought? That's a question. You might wonder, what do you mean, where do I fit in? Exactly. Ask yourself, who am I in relation to the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Am I really a follower? Am I really someone who is interested in what he said? Or do I just call myself a follower and I'm not really interested in doing much? Am I from among those who perhaps hasn't thought deeply as to what exactly I am, or who exactly I am, what I stand for, what I'm supposed to be doing? We all utter the shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. I bear witness that I will never render an act of worship to anyone besides Allah, because there is none worthy of worship besides Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah, the final messenger, meaning he got a message from Allah to give to us. So I'm grateful that I am part of those who has received the message, calling myself a member of his ummah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what it is. So now my duty is to follow. How can I follow without knowing what to follow? So primarily I need to learn. All of us need to make an effort to learn. All of us. From the time we were little children, if we were lucky and fortunate, our parents were bothered about the amount of Islamic knowledge we had. So even if we went to secular schools, they would be bothered to say, listen, let me get a tutor to come and teach you. Go to a madrasa, go to the community madrasa perhaps, and learn the minimum at least. When I say the minimum at least, it's because they as parents felt that as Muslims you need to know something. I need to know how to read salah, I need to know how to read the Quran, I need to know a little bit of the du'as that need to be made, what's halal and haram, permissible, prohibited, etc. So if you were lucky, they would send you to a madrasa. But that's only up to a certain period of time, very limited learning. Beyond that, you grow up. When you grow up, wallahi, my brothers and sisters, 90% if not more of us are guilty of having withdrawn ourselves. What that means is, we are happy with what we had. Can you read Quran? Yeah, by the way, I can just read Alam tara qul huwallah qul ya ayyuhal kafirun, one or two other surahs and that's it. But my brother, you are now so old. Come on, don't forget about what your parents did for you. What have you as an adult done towards your faith, your religion? How much time have you spent to build your palace in the hereafter, when you spend so much time trying to save money to buy a house in Kumalo, for example, in somewhere in Bulawayo, because you know that you need some form of surety and security? Yet when you die, all that surety and security is a waste of time. You will need surety and security beyond the grave. That will only come if you really understand who you are. That's it. That's what we are saying. That's why I'm here today, to share with you something very beautiful. My brothers and sisters, your duty is to learn. So what has Allah done for you? He knows you become lazy. He knows I've become technologically savvy. He knows everything. He knows that now I cannot memorize even the phone numbers of the most beloved people to me. How am I going to memorize extra surahs? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, may Allah forgive us. But it's a reality. Allah knows this. So what Allah does for us is He changes the way, the methods through which you shall learn, and makes them easier. So there was a time when the only way of learning was talaqqi. Talaqqi meaning you sat with the ustad. There were no books because people couldn't really read and write. This was prior to the reading and writing age. And they would sit and make you memorize things. Repeat something, you repeat it. Repeat it, you repeat it. That's how Rasulullah ﷺ got the Quran from Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. Beautiful, absolutely amazing, wonderful. And they memorized it. Thereafter, they wrote it down. As writing became the in thing, people started writing. Initially, they used to write on skins. They used to write on little pieces of wood. They used to write on various other parchments and so on, and preserve it and keep it. And it was a big deal to be able to read and write, because you were now a person a little bit more advanced than those who couldn't read or write. What happened? There came a time when reading and writing became the norm. Everyone was reading and writing, mashallah. I'm sure in this masjid, every single one of you reads and writes, mashallah. But now Allah knows that you read and write, but you take it for granted. Why? Because now you're living in the digital age. It's no longer to do with reading and writing. I'm lazy. How many of you have read a full book in the last 5 years? The answer is 1%, 2%. Maybe in Bulawayo might be 3%, because you guys are a little bit more educated, inshallah. But when it comes to other places, they'll tell you honestly, we haven't read a full book in the last 5 years. In the last 5 years, I don't want to say put up your hand, but I can guarantee you, you guys, I haven't read a full book, perhaps, maybe. I might, well, mind you, I have. But the thing is, it's quite difficult for us to get positive answers, yet we read and write. We take it for granted. So Allah says, hang on. We want to give you no excuse. You know, when you want to, when you're attracted to the opposite sex, mashallah, it's a good sign. It's not a bad sign. It's a sign that, alhamdulillah, things are okay, okay? You're attracted to the opposite sex, but you need to get married. So in order for things to happen properly, and Allah knows you have a desire that is normal and natural, He makes it easy for you to do nikah, but you make it difficult upon yourself, or culture, or society, or family. Allah says, watch out, I made it easy for you. It takes you 35 seconds to go through the paces of nikah, but you took 3.5 years, or 35 years. You kept on living in haram. What was the point? So similarly, Allah makes things very, very easy for us. He knows to know, to have knowledge is absolutely vital. It's the first step. It's what? The first step. Because without knowledge, I can't follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah. What is the sunnah? I don't even know what it means, because I haven't even known knowledge. So Allah says, I'll make it easy for you. You no longer read books. Okay. I am coming up with something. I will give my creatures, the human beings, the ability to come up with technology that will be so much easier for you, in the form of a radio program. You just turned on the radio. Subhanallah. What happened? You started hearing things that other people learned from the books. Wow. But guess what? You still didn't turn on the radio, because you told yourself, ZBC, why should I listen? It's a waste. It's boring. Oh, that Maulana again. That Sheikh again. Look at him. He's telling us this and that. Switch it off. So Allah says, hang on. We make it a little bit more interesting. We'll have for you the television. Subhanallah. It will come up and you will learn what you would be learning in the books and the kitabs, but from something that you're used to watching in a wrong way. Now we're coming up, and in a right way, we will beam it to you. Are you ready? We've brought it to your house. That's the question. That's the issue. Are you ready? You were lazy to come to the madrasa. You were lazy to read a book. You were lazy to sit in a lesson in the masjid. You were lazy to sit in the tafsir. So far that you were lazy to come early for Jumu'ah to listen to the talk once a week. That's how lazy. Allah says, okay, no problem. It's on the telly at home. Are you ready to flick the button? There too, we become lazy. When it comes to Bollywood and Hollywood and Nollywood and Zollywood and Tollywood, we are so fast. What do? Click, click, and we're sitting there. A thief can enter the home and clear it, and we're still watching the soap, and we're crying. We're crying. You know, when soap gets into your eyes, what happens? You all know what happens. You start crying. So what? You're busy watching something and you're crying. Subhanallah, my brothers and sisters, Allah says, hang on, flick it one more time, and you will get qala Allahu wa qala Rasulu. Allahu Akbar. Flick it one more time. Get to the right channel. The same thing. You will now hear what Allah has to say. Do you have an answer on the day when Allah will ask you, my worshipper, I made it so easy for you to learn. You had to sit at home and you had to either turn on a radio or put on a disc, a CD, a DVD, an MP3, or perhaps a flash drive, etc. And you didn't do that. Or the question is, did you do that? So my brothers and sisters, spend the time, make the effort, and dedicate a portion of your week if you are really weak. If you're a weak person, once a week. And if you're stronger, once a day. Why not? Every day you would like to go to work, wouldn't you? Every day, how much do you earn? A daily basis is not too much. Some people might tell you $5, some people $10, some people $1,000 a day. I don't think there's anyone who earns $1,000 a day, but if they do, you're lucky. Alhamdulillah, that's good. But you have to go to work every day. You miss a day, what happens? Chop, they cut off your salary, right? So Islamically, it's much more important for me to earn reward, to be able to come close to Allah. Can't I spend 10 minutes a day, 20 minutes a day, learning a little bit? How do I make money for the akhirah? If I were to give you a book and tell you, listen, take this book, it's how to make money, quick money, and it's guaranteed you're going to make it very fast. What will you do? I swear you're going to sit exactly where you are without moving, without talking, without looking at other people, reading the book, and you're going to be nodding your head and say, I'll do this, I'll do this, I'll do that. Because this $200, this $2,000, this $20,000, ooh, by the time I'm finished, by next week, I'll have $25,000, yo. And then you close the book. And people will say, I've been talking to you for half an hour and you haven't listened. Say, don't worry, I'm doing something more important. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, what Allah has given us in terms of the deen is more valuable than that. Come on. Don't you agree with me? So I want to speak to you about something even higher than just the television or perhaps a CD or a radio program, etc. And I'm talking here about using these tools in the right way. I'm not promoting the wrong use of any of these things. Using them in the right way, the correct channels. Now, there are something called applications that you can get on your phone. It's an app. What is an app, you might ask? Don't you dare pretend like you don't know. Because you know what an application is. Android app, you have these iPhone, you know, the app store, and you know people actually pay to buy these little apps to be able to be in touch with whatever they want to do things. MashaAllah, nowadays you have applications. How do these applications work? Someone, somewhere, somehow put their mind to it, they invested either for purposes of the deen or the dunya, and in the case of Islamic knowledge, it's for the deen, and they made an application in order to bring together Islamic learning, and the effort that was required to do that, you don't even know. For you, it's just a click of the button. A click of the button. You download the app. But no, you say, I can't download the app. Why? Because my phone is full. Well, delete some of the pictures. A large percentage of those pictures might not even be halal pictures, subhanallah. They might not even be halal pictures. Like I say, you know, when you see someone and they really have something to hide, they've got, you know, you get a double security on the phone. They've got triple security on the phone. They've got a thumbprint, they've got a code and an iris scanner. And then did it and it opens. My brother, what do you have to hide? So much security, more than the American president is on your phone, man. Come on. Relax. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. You can have something to deter maybe the kids or someone from getting access, but so deep. The idea is if you have something to hide, perhaps you need to consider deleting it if it is haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. Download this app. You choose the speaker you want. Who do you like to hear? Which imam of the harams salah would you like to hear? What would you like to be motivated by? Choose the name. Get down there, pick the name. You click on it, the app is downloaded. Every time that person talks, every time that person says something, if you are really bothered, your ustad, so to speak, in inverted commas, or your teacher, say what you want. Every time they do something, your phone will have a message to say there is a new lecture. You want to listen to it? Listen to it. It's available for you. Do you know that? And it's free, totally free. Subhanallah. One such application is the one I use, and the one I'm a part of, and I want to share it with you today. It is called Muslim Central. That is the name of the website. So if you say muslimcentral.com, we have so many speakers, a wide selection. In fact, there's a few languages now, and we have thousands of lectures, and so many of these speakers, myself included, this talk as well that I'm delivering now, within 5 to 10 minutes of me walking out or getting into an area where there is decent internet, a press of the button and subhanAllah, it's up. It goes out to more than 100,000 mobile phones almost instantly, or depending on the settings that you have chosen. It gets to you as soon as you are interested in it, and people listen to it within moments. By this afternoon, we'll have thousands of people who would have heard what I said here in Bulawayo. But why I raise this is because Learning has become so easy. Where are we? Allah made it simple. If I give you a big book and say, brother, read this, you're going to think, ooh, when am I going to finish this thing here? When am I going to finish this thing here? But I'm telling you, listen, it's technology. It is so attractive. It is magnetizing. Use it. It's beautiful. You want Quranic recitation? It's there. So Muslim Central has many applications for many speakers on the Android platform. And they have it also on the iTunes platform. And they have it on the website itself. If you want to see it, they have a Facebook page, a Twitter page, etc. You can follow the right things. A lot of us, we're on Twitter, we're on Instagram. And where else are we? We're on perhaps, you know, Vine and Snapchat and everything else. Yes, there is a permissible usage of these things and there is a prohibited usage of these things, just like a knife and a gun. Okay, if you are a true Muslim, at least when people see your profile, they'll be able to say this person's inclined more towards the deen than the dunya. And say you're a Muslim who's a little bit weak, at least people recognize this person's a Muslim, they've got some link. But with us, the reality is I have gone through a lot of Muslim people's profiles that are public and there's no sign that they are Muslim besides the name. Can't you change that? Can't you change that? Besides the name, you know, by the name is Muhammad bin Abdullah, something, something, or Fatima binti Khadija, or something like that. MashaAllah, beautiful name. We hope, alhamdulillah, people are okay. But don't be shy to relate. I follow this guy, I follow that sister, for example, the sisters, or you can even follow a person who's a sheikh, who's a male, for example, if you want to benefit from them. There's no harm in that. I've benefited from this person tremendously. That's a gift of Allah. My brothers and sisters, make use of these gifts. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. There are people who've spent money, effort, time, and so much of their resources in order to get this to you. And we just go ahead. Sometimes we might say, well, we didn't know about it. Well, now you know, subhanallah. So, inshallah, we can download the Muslim Central app with the name you want. Say, for example, my name. If you want to search Mufti Menk, you will get so many applications. The one that is sanctioned by me or the one that I'm involved with completely is called Muslim Central. So that you know, it's definitely sanctioned by me. If you download that, I promise you, you'll get every lecture as it's delivered, no matter where in the world, for as long as I have chosen to upload it. That's it. How simple. And if there is a video link to it, the chances are perhaps you're going to get a video link there as well. Some of the countries that are more advanced, where the internet is a little bit cheaper or sometimes even free, they prefer video over audio. I know when I was in the UK recently, a lot of the kitchens have these television screens that are computer friendly. There's a word for it which doesn't come to my mind right now. But subhanallah, they from their phone or straight onto the screen, they can watch whichever lecture they want, whatever tilawa they want, whatever they want. A lot of the Muslim sisters in the kitchens are preferring not to watch their soaps and not to watch these movies and so on, but rather listen to something regarding your deen. That's a very good sign. But the question is, with us, how much are we doing? It's no longer waiting for someone to come to your city. No, you have access to them before they come to your city. When I was coming through here, I stopped in Gweru. We had a bit of tea there, and mashallah, the masjid, as you know, is renovated. It's looking quite smart, alhamdulillah. We make dua for whoever made that possible, because it's only the hearts of those who are close to Allah that actually feel that they, for the sake of Allah, without even wanting to be known, they want to do things, you know, for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obviously through proper channels and so on. But it's so good, alhamdulillah. When I stopped there, the imam asks me, so when are you going to come to Gweru for a program? I said, my brother, I have programs every day in Gweru. And I think he didn't know where that was going. And I told him, turn on your phone. I can show you how to get it. That's all. Because it just comes in onto your phone. I once went to a restaurant and we asked for the menu. Can we see the menu? They said, turn on your phone and Bluetooth. Turn on phone and Bluetooth. Next thing, we turn on phone, Bluetooth, they pair the device and the whole menu is on your own phone. And I'm thinking, wow, technology. And then I said, no, I can't do this because I know you might hack into my system here. So then the brother says, no, you got to trust us. I said, well, that's something. However, when it comes to lectures, that's it, you download, you can listen straight from there. I know of a brother in Nigeria, in one of the rural areas where they don't have internet, he drives or he catches a lift somehow to the city where there's internet, he downloads the lectures, he goes back to his village and he has his little speakers, the people come together as a community and wallahi he plays these lectures. And the week finishes, during the week he goes back to the city to download more lectures and he goes back. He is the sheikh of the society. How? He's not talking, but he's facilitating it. The problem with us is, I know life is difficult and I know we are struggling and I know economically things are not so easy, but we have to make the time. My brothers and sisters, in our societies, a lot of the times, we are so interested in building our dunya, our life, our world, that wallahi we forget to build the akhirah. I'm just being honest. I'm not being harsh. I'm being totally honest. We are so engrossed in going to work every morning, coming back. Wallahi, sometimes we forget to build the akhirah. So the message I have for you is, make use of this. It's really good. It's something brilliant. And you know what? Convey it to others. Because when you convey good messages to others, say each one of you talks to 10 people about the Muslim Central app or the Muslim Central page, go and choose the speakers. You'll be surprised how many speakers there are. And you'll be surprised how much money and effort has been used. And yet it's free. There's no advertisements. A lot of the people, they have adverts, you know, and that's how they make their money. Muslim Central, no adverts, nil. You download it. They said, because what's the point of listening to an Islamic talk? And just before that, you're listening to something about alcohol, something about something haram and so on. But if each one of us conveys the message to 10 people, imagine the reward we would get. You know, when you talk to one person, the hadith says you guide one person, it's better for you than the most expensive and valuable of conveyance of this world. What about if I spoke to 10 people, encourage them, speak about it now and again, forward. And I'm going to perhaps end on this note. I can't really see the clock there for some reason. There's a fan in the way. So you've got to excuse me to look at my own clock here. Okay. A lot of the times we use the phones. You know, we have WhatsApp. I think it's the most common WhatsApp at the moment in our part of the world. You might have Telegram and various other platforms. Ask yourself, how much of Islamic content that is interesting that I forward? I tell you why I use the word interesting. Wallahi, I have done a little study, and that study is asking people about how they receive Islamic clips and how much they listen to and who they listen to it from. So you know what they say? They say, if there is a guy who sends us long and uninteresting messages every day, then we just see the message, and just to get the green ring off that name, we just open the message and close it immediately. We haven't even seen what they've said, because we know that it's a long message from here all the way to Harare. I'll be reading and I might even knock a few cars in the way. But at the same time, what you need to know is, if it's a short, sharp message, they know this person only sends really interesting stuff, they'll stop and read it. That's the beauty. Today, the concentration levels are not more than 1.5 minutes. That's why, while I'm talking, I'm trying to make it interesting. I'm moving from pillar to post. Can you notice? And I'm trying to crack a little joke or two. Not because I want to, but because I have to. I have to hold your concentration. 3 minutes is maximum. We're going on for almost 30 minutes here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. You cannot every day have 30 minutes of time of all of the people. So when you are forwarding things on WhatsApp, make sure it's interesting, very interesting. Make sure it's calling towards the deen somehow, even if it's through a lighter moment. A lot of us, wallahi, there's a dirty joke that came through. And what do? You think about all your friends. Quick, quick. Hey, this guy will have a good laugh. And if someone, hey, send it to me. You'll even phone him at night. Hey, that joke you said today, please don't forget to forward it to me. Wallahi, it's reality on the ground. How many of us, you heard a beautiful recital, say, hey, brother, please send me that recitation. Listen to the recital. Even if you're, you know, in the public and you're listening to a recital, wallahi, it's so soothing. It's so beautiful. Others will also get the good vibe from that recital, because you and I know the recitation is the word of Allah. It has a power to it that is far more than anything can offer you. So forward something interesting. It needs to be short. It needs to be calling towards the deen, and it mustn't bombard or flood the person's inbox or the person's WhatsApp. You see how many messages? Hey, 35 messages from this brother today. I wonder what he's saying. Anyway, we'll see tomorrow. You defeated the purpose, one at a time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. May He guide us. Really, indeed, I've come here to let you know that we all fit in somewhere. How we fit in is, we need to be able to learn, put into practice, convey it to others. And Allah's made it easy, so easy. Please, my brothers and sisters, get this application, put it on your phone, go and search for it, spend a little bit of time, see what it's all about, benefit from it, talk to others about it, and while you're sitting at home, your investment will be already reaping a lot of its fruits. You know, like putting $1,000 and already you're seeing $100 a